Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Jedi, Sith, Mandalorians, Twi'leks, younglings that survived Order 66, and everybody in between, to another exciting edition of the new Force Order.
For life.
It's a Star Wars podcast, if you haven't figured that out by now. It's a podcast by us, the new Force Order, the Doc, the Butcher, and the Greek, a.k.a. the fans, and it's for you, the fans. I am one third of your hosts. I am a pro wrestler. I am a Star Wars geek. I am your boy, GGP, aka Greek God Papadon. Besides me, there's two other fine gentlemen venturing on this ride. One of them happens to be a pretty, witty, kung fu grip having thunder stealing medical droid, and the other is a vindictive, pissed off, malicious Sith Lord. Boys, introduce yourselves.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Dark Lord of the podcast, the Sith Ari, the Rampaging Revan Kiss, the Butcher, your boy Spiro, a.k.a. Darth Spiridon.
And I am smarter than 2-1-B, more technical than FX7, the God of Steel and Thunder. And the man who is pretty much sure that we witness a Death Star explosion today in Beirut. God bless those people. Dr. Destroyo, Alex Arroyo.
Well, my heart goes out to all those people, unfortunately, who had suffered losses or were injured by that explosion. But we're not here to talk about politics. We're not here to talk about shenanigans and tomfoolery. We're not here to talk about anything related to the real world. We're really here today to talk to you, the fans, about a galaxy far, far away. A.K.A. Star Wars. Now, not much happened this week regarding news. Slow week. But we'll do the best to entertain you guys. Usually the Doc, usually the Butcher, and myself, we like to banter back and forth. We like to bust each other's balls. But this week, we're going to keep it nice and simple. There's a saying, K-I-S-S, keep it simple, stupid. But in this case, it's keep it simple, scruffy nerf herder, because we want you, the fans, not only be entertained, but be able to understand what we are spewing at you guys. So, Doc, why don't you enlighten these masses of some of the headlines I dropped this week, because I can't do it.
You want me to start spewing right now? I'll start spewing. Hold
spew,
on.
Spew, spew,
spew. Spew the venom.
Goosh, 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 goosh. All right. So there was a couple of things that showed up this weekend. One was a tweet by our friend Taika Waititi, who apparently was nominated for an Emmy for his portrayal of IG-11 in The Mandalorian. And apparently everybody gets excited when Taika tweets, because it's always some interesting, witty little, like, you know, quip or his quote that he says. And I really think this was a slow news week because it was really fucking, you know, they were tickling his balls for no apparent reason. Nominated for an Emmy, great. He put, some actors are so good that they don't even need to use their face. The entire planet is buzzing about me being nominated for my incredibly robotic acting as IG-11 in The Mandalorian. Guys, there are other nominees outside of the coveted voice actor category. It can't be all about me all the time. Thank you. Enjoy the show. And he thanked Filoni and Favreau. They made the tweet sound like the second coming of God. It was not. Again, slow news week. They're going to pick up whatever the fuck they want to pick up to make life all exciting and bullshit. Okay, whatever. Speaking about exciting and bullshit, we got a little bit of disappointing news this week as well. And of course, it was guised in the clickbait genre that websites love to do. Looper, which has kind of been plus or minus hot or cold when it comes to information, put out this article that basically says, and I quote, fans of The Mandalorian just got dealt a major disappointment. So when you see that, you're like, oh no, season two is going to be delayed.
That's what I thought, yeah.
Ashley Eckstein fell off a fucking boat in the Caribbean. She's dead. Rosario Dawson got a massive case of space herpes. She can't fucking come out to play. But no, they give us the fucking old circle jerk and put in some bullshit story about some of the books that we had talked about previous shows, like The Art Of and the novelization that they're doing, are going to be delayed. And it looks like the novel, which I don't think, based on what they were talking about, is not going to follow the script of season one, is going to be delayed till 2021. Well, guess what, sunshine? We live in COVID land now, motherfucker. Everything is delayed. Not a big deal. But guess what's not going to be delayed? Season two of The Mandalorian. Still slotted for October on Disney Plus. So you know what? You could delay The Mandalorian's underwear fucking underoo release. You could delay his, you know, his shirts under his fucking under his helmet because his breath tastes like shit. Who cares? We're getting season two. We're getting season two on time. Everything else, extraneous nonsense. No one really fucking cares about Disney. Bring it on. And thanks, Looper, for fucking clickbaiting us.
Looper, man, you know, of all people, I've enjoyed a lot of their content, whether it's on YouTube or the website. And for them to come out and do this shit, man, I was like, no way, no fucking way. When you guys originally shared that link, I was like, please don't tell me this shit's going to be fucking postponed because I'm going to cancel my fucking subscription. Thankfully, I read it. And yeah, man, fuck the books. Fuck everything else. I mean, it sucks
if you're
a collector, but what everybody wants is fucking season two of The Mandalorian. It's coming, and that's that, man, you know?
See, I don't know what's more fake news or clickbait, that article from Looper or the fact that he says that Spiro says he has a subscription to Looper. We know he don't.
Oh, no, 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 no. I'm sorry. Let me go ahead and clarify. Not my subscription to Looper, but to Disney Plus.
Wow. Okay, sorry. That makes sense.
Fake news, motherfucker.
Didn't Ryan Johnson direct Looper? So Spirit would definitely not have a fucking subscription to that.
No, definitely, dude. Definitely.
Fucking.
Again, folks, slow news week. Not much have come out this week. What else came out?
I tell you what did come out. That was Ray Park's penis on fucking Instagram.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, that's a segue right there. Segue of the year.
Oh, my goodness. All right. So we touched upon this very slightly, like, I think, last week, but there was still some news coming out from it. Apparently, our buddy Ray. Listen, it's the easiest thing in the world to say you got hacked. I'd be like, yo, I got hacked. I don't know what happened, Disney. But apparently, he himself had posted a video of, like you said, Pop, last week, him getting the old double-bladed lightsabers shined up at the old cantina over there. it was up for a very unspecified period of time. Someone had a screenshot or a screen recorded, I'm assuming, because it's got to be out there. I looked. I couldn't find it. So old Snake Eyes over there was giving the old one eye to some chick.
And, how long were you holding on to that one, Doc?
my hands are totally free. I'm not holding on to anything. had the video up for a short period of time and then it disappeared. So, but obviously, as the internet goes, anything you throw up there lasts forever. So Ray fessed up to it. He said that he's the one who did it, and his wife came out and talked about the fact that
But he said it was an accident. It was he didn't do it intentionally. He put up the wrong video.
It's hilarious. And his wife came out and was talking because there was something going on back and forth between Daniel Logan and some other shit. And the people were saying that they all got hacked, that Daniel Logan was fucking his wife. I have no idea. It's Jesus kind Christ, of like, man. It's tits up and it's very, very confusing. But his wife released a statement that, you know, went on talking about, I stand by my husband, blah, 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 all this and this. She really was trying to kind of skirt around the whole thing and telling people that she's not answering any questions about it, not answering any messages about it, so don't even try it, but she's standing by her husband. But the rumor goes is that somebody is not standing by Ray Park. That's going to be Mickey Mouse. People have come out and said that there's good evidence and good reports that Disney will not be using Ray Park any longer to reprise the role of Darth Maul for any mocap stuff or any live action.
I hope that's not the case.
I really hope it's not the case as well. I mean, you know, he's synonymous with the character, and it's going to be difficult for us to implant anybody else to see them in that role as well. But
you
Disney,
know what, man?
Disney.
Yeah, I keep hearing that people are talking about Sam Witwer taking over that role. Listen, man, at the end of the day, man, everybody's entitled to a life. Everybody's entitled to their private life. Everybody's entitled to make a mistake, okay? And the problem today is that in a nation where everybody's talking about social justice and that we can't go after people, you know, and everybody's innocent until proven guilty and this and that, and, you know, why doesn't that apply to Ray Park? Why is everybody automatically assuming that he did it on purpose? And maybe he fucking did. But everybody's also assuming that he beat his daughter maybe or some shit. I don't know, man. You know, everybody's jumping to all these fucking conclusions. We don't know the full story. We don't know shit, man, to be honest, okay? Yep. There was some damage control. Maybe some people bought into it. Maybe some are skeptical. I don't know, man. But you know, who the fuck are these fans to be judge, jury, and executioner?
It's 2020. They're like that all over the
2020.
Place.
2020.
Well, listen, man. Here's the deal. His wife came out and said, "No, all that other scenarios between Danny Logan herself, the rumor about him being an abusive father is all nonsense and totally 100% fictional, not true." And shouldn't have, I mean, obviously, if that's the case, then, you know, whether it's damage control or whether it's the truth, she's come out on the public forum and stated, you know, that as her case. So that should exonerate him of any wrongdoing. The only wrongdoing he did was post a video by what he claims is by accident. And that's it. Let's move on. And I'm not just saying that because we're all mall marks, but it wasn't like he posted a video where, you know, he was smacking a chick around or beating up a child or anything.
Mushroom
like that.
Tattooing her, I think. But
yeah, but
even
you know
if he did that, some people like that shit, bro.
Well, look, we're not justifying any of that. All I'm just
of course not. I'm just saying.
All I'm saying is that whatever he does in his private time and whatever he's into, whether it's voyeurism, whatever, open relationships, whatever, that's his business. It's not ours, you know? But regardless, let's not dwell too much on the negativity. We know we have a show that likes to dwell on the dark side. We'll talk about the dark side. But what else has come out this week?
I just hope it wasn't one of these chubby Comic-Con chicks. Darth Maul deserves better.
Well, I think you're just jealous because that's your old gimmick.
It is. You're right. It is my old gimmick. I'm still taking applications, ladies. If you dress like Ursula in Comic-Con, you just knock on my door, girl.
Ursula.
Or He-Man.
Nice. One or the other. I'm down. there was, speaking of the Mandalorian, there's also another rumor kicking around about how Maz Kanata was in possession of the Skywalker lightsaber. Some people think that, you know, at the end of that episode, at the end of the issue of the Star Wars comic book, where Luke drops the saber and someone catches it, that the end of that hand may belong to one Ahsoka Tano. And maybe we'll see the...
Yeah, but you know what, dude? I sent you guys the video, not to cut you off. I'm sorry, Doc. I sent you guys a video where they touch base on the storyline where Luke had a vision, and in that vision, that's the person who grabs the saber.
Yeah.
But actually, the saber actually fell down to where the scrap heap is, and some Ugnaught found it after Luke bounced because he tried to use the force to grab the lightsaber. It wasn't coming to him. I guess it was under too much rubble, and he had to leave. And then finally, when he left, that's when the Ugnaught found it, and... You know, he realized he didn't need the saber anymore. He'll make his own saber, or whatever the case may be. So now we have to find out where it went from, how it got from the Ugnaught to Maz Kanata. And to be honest with you, I read the article. It was from Screen Rant, right?
Yes, sir.
And yeah. It was more theory and what if. So I don't want to dwell on it too much. Not to bury the lead here, but right. You know, we can make up a storyline and throw it up there as a what if possibility. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
Yeah. My only question about that is, I believe that was part of his Jedi trials, right? So if he didn't retrieve that lightsaber, is he officially, like his father, not granted the title of master? Not that there was anybody around to actually, you know, grant him that title, but you know.
Listen, I think there was, I think Yoda said it best, you know, in Return of the Jedi when he says, I came back from my training. He says, no more Jedi you need. And he goes, well, I am a Jedi now, you know, and he's like, you still must confront Vader, and he did. So I think he full fledged, he paid his dues to become a Jedi. As far as they're giving the rank of master, maybe in a comic book, his father came back and granted him the rank of master via Force Ghost, or Obi-Wan, or Yoda, you know what I'm saying? Or Qui-Gon, who knows? But like you said, when you're the last Jedi, it doesn't matter. You can call yourself master.
Yeah, you can say whatever you want.
Twice on Sundays. Who's going to debate you?
If they do, it'll be a master debate.
Any other news, bro?
Let's see what else we got here. Interesting title, which I love the triple entendre they gave it. One of the boys, Carl Urban, was the real McCoy in The Rise of Skywalker. Now, if you understand all those movie references, you will get a pop culture gold star from Doc today. One of the boys, so Carl Urban plays the lead in The Boys, Billy Butcher, which if you haven't watched The Boys on Amazon.
Excellent show, man.
Fantastic show. Season 2 debuts next month. Cannot wait. The thing was fire from the start. It's adapted from a Garth Ennis comic book. It is a little bit different than the comic, but still a fantastic show. It was awesome. I got Sharon into it, my wife, and she is begging for season 2 right now. And it's just, she was like, oh, I don't want to watch this, you know, the comic book bullshit, but she got into it. So that's the one of the boys. The real McCoy kicks to the fact that he played Bones McCoy in the reboot of Star Trek, which was a good choice for him. And then apparently he was one of the stormtroopers in Rise of Skywalker because they're throwing everybody bones in Hollywood who wants to be a Star Wars actor. So the portion of the movie where you see the Knights of Ren and Kylo Ren walk through the destroyer as they're kind of marching through the ship.
So it's like a backstage segment of Raw.
Exactly. 100%. And one of the stormtroopers goes, the Knights of Ren. Apparently he said that was him.
That was him, really?
That's what he said, that was him. He came out and said that. But you know what? Michael Jackson came out and said that he was the guy standing next to him when he said that was him. No, it's... Who the fuck knows? Who's ever going to fucking dispute that except the stormtrooper who's actually in the costume who has 4 Twitter followers? Nobody gives a shit, you know? It's
Yo, can I just say, Carl Urban, right? Yo, and shout out to Homeboy 88 for this one. But, if fucking Keanu Reeves doesn't ever play Revan, yo, Carl Urban, I think, would be fucking great to play that role, especially when he goes in full on, you know, what do you call it, crusader mode and shit.
Wait a minute, are you talking about the Scott Levy biopic?
Scott Levy biopic.
Yeah. Oh, you said Revan. I thought you said Raven. Sorry.
Raven.
Yeah, Revan's not canon. Oh. We're not getting him.
Oh, in. Scott Levy. All right, got you.
Johnny Polo.
Gotti Flamingo.
Doflamingo. But see, I don't think Carl Urban would do that, because why would you go from something that is canon to not canon? I don't understand why you would ever do that.
I agree. It's like taking a shower with a raincoat on. Makes no sense.
It's like getting a hand job after getting a blow job. It just doesn't fucking work anymore.
I got a special episode of The Butcher's Black coming soon, because to be honest, man, Revan has turned into Disney's whore. They're milking him for all he's worth, but yet they won't acknowledge him as being canon. And
that's a very good segue to the next thing I wanted to bring up. As you posted, Spiro, I'm sure it was you, because I saw the headline, the Darth Revan lightsaber commercial that Hasbro put out this week, that was actually a pretty fantastic commercial. So initially, I hadn't bought the saber when it went on sale, because it's a little expensive, and I had about a zillion other things I was pre-ordering that week.
That are canon.
But it's actually a really nice piece. It has kyber crystals that you could take in and take out, which is the first mass release non-Galaxy's Edge lightsaber that's actually doing that. So you could put in the red or the purple yet, right? I think.
Yeah.
And then it has sound effects, as we always know. And it also has this this crash effect where when you hit it, like the tip of the lightsaber turns whitish like it would normally if you do it on the in the movie. The commercial was pretty put together, and Revan was there. I mean, like I said, the experience is pop. This joke, we have to get it in as much as possible. Just like the end of a bad divorce, you got to get it in as much as possible, because we may not be able to use it again. Because it's coming to the point where
Spiro just said that Revan is getting milked for everything that he's worth and not getting any notoriety by Disney. So basically, what Spiro just said is that Revan is the husband of the relationship. So
there you go. Yeah.
You know. Exactly. Anyway, boys, let them know where they can find you guys at, and let's take this bad boy home.
You can find me at Dr. Dr. underscore Destroyo, DESTROYO, the gram of Insta. Alex Arroyo on Facebook, Alex Arroyo MD on Twitter.
You can find my Revenly heartbroken ass on Instagram, Spiro underscore A, Darth underscore Spiriton, Rational.Rage, all of those on Instagram, Facebook page, Rational Rage. That's it.
You can find me at Greek God Papadon on Twitter, Instagram, Demetrius Papadon on Facebook. Pro Wrestling Tee / Greek God Papadon is the wrestling t-shirt store. Freak Out Papadon is my YouTube page. Subscribe, like, hit the notification bell. You can find the three of us all together at NFO underscore podcast, Twitter, New Force Order, Instagram, official New Force Order, Facebook. New Force Order is the YouTube page where you can watch this video. Or if you're listening to this on a podcast, on a, you know, audio, just do yourself a favor. Go to YouTube, type it in the search bar. Subscribe to the page, like the video, hit the notification bell, and comment. Most importantly, next, when you can catch us all week long with our different shows that the NFO is bringing you guys. So I want each and every one of you people out there to email us in the future regarding any topics, regarding any of the shows. And the email address is newforceorder@yahoo.com. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for giving us your ears, your time, your eyes. And thank you for letting us entertain you even another week when we make chicken salad out of soup shit, like Spiro likes to say, because this has been a slow news week. This has been another exciting edition of the New Force Order.
For life.
And that's just too sweet.
Henceforth, execute order NFO. Oh.